Hi all, so boilerplates, that's what this is about, yes. So boilerplates are magical things. They can let you do something like this, create an entire JavaScript application in under 12 seconds. But also, when you start as a programmer, me myself, I'm self-taught. I didn't went to some informatics or computer science school, so I taught myself how to program. And sometimes you feel like this. I'm not sure if I'm good at programming or just good in copy-pasting stuff. So let's start by explaining what a boilerplate actually is. So a boilerplate can be multiple things. If you ask the internet, it's a standardized pieces of code. But if you ask me, it's something different. A boilerplate is also a get-rich-quick scheme. Like, you get a high rate of return for small investment. You install something, in under 12 seconds, you have an entire application. But why? It's high return, small investment. So why it's high return, small investment? You can skip the entire project setup. Everything's already done for you. You can get started real quick without having to set up any development. Also, architecture choices are already made. Do you want to filter your structure by type, or by future, or maybe by page or view? It's already made for you, so you don't have to do it anymore. And also, you have a very contributing developer community. So if you have any problems with any of the material, you just go to GitHub or some Slack channel and you ask about how you can solve this problem you're having. So I hear you all thinking, why is this bad? It isn't necessarily bad, but for me, I'm a self-taught programmer and I went to economics school. And I've learned high returns and low investments also mean high risk. So it isn't without risk to use a boilerplate. And that's mainly because it's not a tailor-made solution. Every project's different, has different choices, need different approaches. And with boilerplates, everything's already done for you. So for example, if you look on GitHub to the number of boilerplates you have, for it's in total, it's almost 80,000. For a JavaScript application, it's 44,000. And one of the most popular React boilerplates has even 25K stars. So probably maybe even 40K people installed this actual boilerplate. So it's very generic code for something that needs a different approach. As you can see the numbers right here. Also, it uses unfamiliar dependencies in code. So you install a new boilerplate, and they probably have a lot of packages and dependencies installed that you don't know, if you maybe don't even need. If we look at this boilerplate, it's a React boilerplate, you can see it has over 100 dependencies installed. And as you might know, these dependencies will also have their own dependencies. So in total, it's a lot of stuff you need to install. So here's another example for a Vue boilerplate. This one also has a lot. So think about all the risks you can have when you install this in terms of debugging all those dependencies. They can get deprecated or something else pops up. Also, the load time, your bundle gets really big with all these dependencies and all the sub-dependencies. And you would also see this problem while you're building it. So you're building your application and you run into numbers of problems due to these large number of dependencies. And the final thing that is a high risk of a boilerplate is the steep learning curve. So imagine installing a React boilerplate and getting Redux or MobX or something else, while you just want to use something for React. You don't have any choices anymore in terms of features to use, dependencies to install, and you all need to learn how these work. So imagine you got some kind of compound bug in your code, then you need to learn how GraphQL works, or Redux works, or MobX works, or any other stuff. So should you no longer use boilerplates? Yes, sure, you should use them, but be wise, and always see if your risk is worth what you get back. So if you want to know more about this, go to Twitter and follow me and tweet about JavaScript everywhere. Thank you.